Some people say crime doesn't live in small towns. One stop sign and two deadbeats named Andy and Barney is enough to keep you crook-free till Christmas. Well, those folks never set foot in the little town that innocence forgot, Central South Carolina. And those folks never met me, Jack Strong, Private Eye.
Don't know why.
It was April. I had planned to spend the evening with my two best friends. They're fun cats, they travel light, one in the holster and the other in a hip flask. I was catching up on the news from the local rag, but I hadn't learned much. Except parking is still bad and some newsy broad really wants academic dead days. Well, for me, every day is a dead day. And the local paper is so bad the fish have started refusing to be wrapped in it. I guess nobody likes having the truth die with them. That's when she walked in. She was a fight-or-flight dame. The kind of girl your father told you to chase and your mother told you to run away from. Just beautiful enough to be dangerous and just shy enough to make you forget it. She wore a dress so tight you could read the label on her underwear. I knew this dish was gonna be trouble, but lucky for me, trouble is on my business card.
I need your help. I hear you're the best detective in town.
Not saying much when the population doubles on game day. What can I do for you?
I need information. I'm a member of a club. You might have heard of it. Facebook?
Heard of it? It's the biggest racket in town. People collecting friends like bad memories.
Are you a member?
I'm against the stupid guy with a microphone at the football games, if that's what you mean.
Well, someone has asked me to be his Facebook friend, and I've never heard of him. His name is Jeff Derrick. I want you to find out who he is.
Doesn't sound like too bad of a fix. Why are you itching so bad to get the mug stored?
I can't say. Is it important to the case?
No, just curious. I'll have my secretary draw up a contract.
Thank you, Mr. Strong.
It's Jack, baby. I'll buzz you when I get results.
Finding the Derrick goose wasn't hard. Being a private eye gets you in a lot of networks. After accepting some ninja versus zombie invitations and confirming that I would go out of my way to step on a crunchy leaf, I was able to find Jeff Derrick's dossier, complete with his home address. I decided to pay him a little visit. I had a hunch I could make the birds sing.
Kid, anybody home?
No, just me.
Listen, kid, when I was your age, Pluto was a planet. People don't just leave a green egg like you home alone, see?
Questions ran through my head like the squirrels that litter the Clemson University campus. Except, those squirrels never run. It actually kind of scares me. They just walk up to you and... Well, anyway. I kept wondering. Was the doll playing me for a sap? Was she in with this giant lug who cooled me and dumped me on a greyhound? Was this some kind of sting? I needed a drink and a clue. One of them I knew where to find.
Well, hey there, Jack. Nice to see you. Say there, what can I get for you?
Hola, Jimmy. Give me the usual.
Sure thing, Jack. Say there, where'd you get that china?
Come on, Jimmy. A guy running a low-class gin mill like this one ought to know better than to ask questions.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jack. I didn't mean to pry.
No, Jimmy, you've been on my friends list for a long time. Don't worry about it. How about a cup of joe while I wait?
Sure thing there, boy.
first I was more lost than a husband in a pottery barn. The goon that had knocked me out was a babysitter? But when I read the name on the check, everything was crystal. I knew I had found my man. All I had to do now was meet him.
Hello. Yes, my name is Mark Zuckerberg. I'm looking for Jeff Derrick. Yes, he's just won our annual Facebook giveaway. $2,000 in scholarship money. I was wondering if there's a time and place I can meet him to give him the money. 8 o'clock at the roller mill tonight? Swell. I'll see him there. Not so fast, Goliath. Or is it Eddie? That's right. I know you're not Jeff Derrick. I know you're just a cheap babysitter with a quick left. You know, you should pick on people your own size, Bruno. Now, I want to meet Jeff Derrick, see? And don't think I don't know what's up. I know the real Jeff Derrick is a skirt named Alice Ross.
How did you know?
The gig is up, Alice. You thought you had it all figured out, didn't you? Your sweet daughter, Desiree Ross, is going off to college, and you want to make sure she doesn't fall in with the wrong crowd. So you make up a fake Facebook profile for some greaser named Jeff Derrick, and you use your thug of a babysitter's personal information as a cover.
But I was only trying to protect her!
Well, spying on her ain't the way to do it, sister. And what's Facebook gonna tell you anyway? A relationship status update here, a drunken spring break photo there? But you couldn't let it be, could you? The one place kids had to take refuge from the prying eyes of parents like you, but you couldn't leave it all alone. Now it's over. As soon as kids find out their parents are on Facebook, they'll be changing the channel like they were listening to WSBF.
My sweet girl, what have I done?
Aw, nothing, Mrs. R. It's just a bad friend request. In a seedy little town like this, they happen every day.
How could she? How could she? Oh!
It's a hard truth to learn, kid, but parents just don't understand.
I hate her!
I'm sorry to hear that. Listen, babe, you owe me $2,000, but how about I take you out to dinner and we call it even?
Oh, Jack, I could never think of us as anything more than just friends. I hope you understand.
Her words hit me like a Catbus. Only the Catbus was named Desiree and had really nice legs. Friends. It's a four-letter word that is rung with a cold clang in the heart of every man who's loved some looker, who's strung him along with pokes and messages and wall notes before she dumped him like last year's course catalog. I've heard it a million times, and I'll probably hear it another million. But that's Jake. Because the only things in this world that ain't worth crying over are broads and a bad hand. I've known both, and neither has chilled me as much on this town's hot nights as the knowledge that there's enough evil here to keep the juice in one man's flask until he dies, or graduates, whichever comes first. Jack Strong, Private Eye. Your sweet daughter, Desiree Ross, is going off to college, and you want to make sure she doesn't fall in with the right crowd. It's going to take me a few times, I'm sorry.
That's fine. I don't know if to look at you or not, because I'm just going to laugh.